Brain of Britain, the nationwide general knowledge contest, chaired by Russell Davis.
Thank you. Hello, you join us and our lively audience at the Radio Theatre in London for the second of our 2020 heats. Four competitors, who I should tell you have come through quite a rigorous process even to get this far, will be answering general knowledge questions for the next half hour as they try to make it through to the next stage of the knockout contest. Let's meet them.
Hello, I'm Graeme Anderson. I'm a retired HR director from Tonbridge in Kent.
Hello, I'm Daniel LAWSON. I'm a medical student from the Wirral.
Hi, I'm Becky LOVEGROVE, a retired music teacher, and I live in Cornwall.
Hello, I'm Nathan MULHOLLAND. I'm an economist and from County Derry.
And you're all very welcome. A place in the semi-finals awaits our winner today, and we also invite the four top-scoring runners-up to the next stage, so it could be more than one of you who makes it through. It really is worth trying for every point you can get. In time-honoured style, we proceed in alphabetical surname order, so would you start things off for us today, please? Graeme Anderson. In the House of Commons, what short question is shouted simultaneously by two doorkeepers when the House rises to leave at the end of the working day?
Sorry, don't know.
Right. Nathan MULHOLLAND.
Division?
No. No, nope, didn't know. Yes, Daniel LAWSON.
Who goes?
No, okay, I'm afraid I can't allow that. Becky LOVEGROVE.
Who goes there?
No. That's a different sort of incident altogether, no. But who goes was very nearly there. It's who goes home, which makes a lot of difference. It's often explained as an invitation to members to join together in bands to cross what in the past were the dangerous unlit fields between Westminster and the city, or to hire boats homeward on the Thames as a party in order to save the individual fares. Same may apply to taxis nowadays, of course. Okay, Daniel LAWSON, we come to you. Which area of southern England was established as a national park in March 2005?
The South Downs?
Not the South Downs, no. Graeme Anderson?
The New Forest?
It was the New Forest. That's a point to you. And Becky LOVEGROVE's question. Which member of the British royal family won an Olympic medal in 2012?
Zara Phillips.
Zara Phillips. Tyndall, yes. If a chemical element has more than one isotope, the isotopes will have the same number of electrons, but differ in the number of what other particle?
Neutrons.
Neutrons is right. In Greek mythology, Zeus commissioned Hephaestus, the god of fire and patron of craftsmen, to create the first mortal woman. What was her name? Okay, out of time. Anybody's question? Daniel LAWSON.
Aphrodite?
No. Not coming in. No. Pandora is the name. Nathan MULHOLLAND. In 2020, the thriller writer Lee Child, whose real name is James Grant, announced that he was stepping back, as they say, from writing duties on his hugely successful series of books featuring Jack Reacher. Who will be taking over writing the series?
No, sorry.
Okay. Yes, Daniel LAWSON.
His brother?
Who is? I think we'll have to accept that, because it is his brother. His brother, Andrew. Andrew Grant, also a successful writer, but it's reported that he too will be using the pseudonym Child. End of the first round, and the scores necessarily small at this stage. Nathan MULHOLLAND yet to score. Daniel LAWSON, Graeme Anderson, one apiece. Becky LOVEGROVE, two. Swiftly on with then to Graeme Anderson again. The town of Wrexham is the largest in North Wales. How do the Welsh spell its name?
W-R-E-C-S-A-M.
That's right. Which Russian physicist and dissident's name is commemorated in an annual prize awarded by the European Parliament to individuals who have made an exceptional contribution to the fight for human rights?
Sakharov?
Yes, Andrei Sakharov, the Sakharov Prize for Freedom of Thought. Which precious stone takes its name from the Greek meaning not intoxicated?
Amethyst.
Well thought. It is amethyst. In ancient times, it was believed you could drink as much as you want and remain sober if you had an amethyst somewhere about your person. Must try that. Very useful. Which ship involved in a major oil disaster in 1989 ended its days with the name Oriental Nicety?
Exxon Valdez?
Yes, it was. It's also been known by names such as Exxon Mediterranean, Sea River Mediterranean, and Dongfang Ocean. Helen Mirren has recently taken on the role of Catherine the Great on TV. Which Hollywood star of the interwar years wrote the 1944 Broadway play Catherine Was Great, in which she took the leading role? Out of time, I fear. Yes, Nathan Mulholland.
Catherine Hepburn.
No. Becky Lovegrove.
Sophia Loren.
No, before her time, I fear. It was Mae West. And naturally, Mae saw to it that all members of her Russian Imperial Guard were played by tall, muscular young men. Daniel Lawson's question. What is the main title of the memoir written by Adam Kay with the subtitle Secret Diaries of a Junior Doctor?
This is going to hurt.
Exactly right, yes. The palmate newt derives its English name from which particular physical characteristic, which is not found in the other British species of newt?
Webbed fingers or toes?
Yes, yes, I think so. The males have webbed back feet, and it's the webbing that counts, yes. What's the title of the song which, around a year ago, achieved chart success partly due to a viral video trend known as the Yeehaw Challenge, which saw people dress up as cowboys while lip-syncing and dancing?
Baby Shark?
No. Out of time. Anyway, no more offers. No. No, it was Old Town Road by Lil Nas X, alias Montero Lamar Hill. And we come to Becky Lovegrove now. The official biography of the broadcaster Alistair Cook was written by which other journalist and broadcaster? A former presenter of The World at One on Radio 4, who died in 2006.
Is it John Sissons?
It wasn't, I'm afraid. GRAEME ANDERSON.
Brian Redhead?
No. No more guesses, no. It was Nick Clark. Well remembered hereabouts, anyway. Nathan Mulholland's question. In a 2019 film by Melina Metsoukas that has been described as a 21st century version of Bonnie and Clyde, British actors Jodie Turner-Smith and Daniel Kaluuya take the two lead roles. What are the names of those characters who also give the film its title?
No.
No, okay. Yes, Daniel Lawson.
Jack and Jill?
Nope. Heads are shaking. The answer is Queen and Slim. There we are, end of a round. Nathan Mulholland yet to score. Becky Lovegrove, 2. Daniel Lawson, 3. GRAEME ANDERSON, 5. Now, GRAEME ANDERSON, this is unusual. With your next question, there's part of a famous piece of English literature to listen to. I'd just like you to name this poem.
My heart aches, and drowsy numbness pains my senses, though of hemlock I had drunk, or emptied some dull opiate to the drains. 1 minute passed, and Lethwoods had sunk. 'Tis not through envy of thy happy lot, but being too happy in thine happiness, that thou, light-winged dryad of the trees, in some melodious plot of beechen green and shadows numberless, singest of summer in full-throated ease.
Ode to a Nightingale?
By John Keats, yes. Did you recognise the reader as well?
No.
No. It was Benedict Cumberbatch. It had to be. It always is these things. Now, Adamstown is the only human settlement on an island group, now a British overseas territory, on which the first Europeans to settle were the survivors of the mutiny on the Bounty. Which island group is this?
Pitcairn.
Yes, total population about 50. Which 19th century novel, with the subtitle A Tale of the Pacific Ocean, tells the adventures of young Ralph Rover and his companions Jack Martin and Peterkin Gay?
Sorry, don't know.
All right. Yes, Becky Lovegrove does.
Coral Island.
By R.M. Ballantyne. You're quite right. Daniel Lawson, in a standard game of Scrabble, only two letters of the alphabet carry a value of 10 points. Can you name both of them?
X and Z?
No. Graeme Anderson?
Z and Q.
Z and Q, those are the two. Becky Lovegrove, we come round to you. Which English actress, his partner for over a decade, duetted with Serge Gainsbourg on the notorious hit song Je t'aime, moi non plus? Daniel Lawson.
Birkin. Jane Birkin.
Jane Birkin is right. Well remembered. Before your time, I dare say, but but you did remember. Nathan Mulholland, the name of which household object is also a slang term for prison, historically a reference to Newgate Prison in particular?
Kettle?
No. Becky Lovegrove.
Is it the clink?
No. Daniel Lawson?
Slammer?
Nope. Graeme Anderson?
Jug.
Jug! Yes, you're right. Here come the scores. And they are as follows. Nathan Mulholland, yet to trouble a scorer. Yes, Becky Lovegrove, 3. Daniel Lawson, 4. Graeme Anderson, 9. Right, at this point in the programme, we give our competitors a chance to sit back and relax for a few moments and work as a team, rather than as rivals. It's time to tackle a couple of questions from a Brain of Britain listener in the interlude we call Beat the Brains. We love receiving your suggestions, which you can email at any time, to brainofbritain@bbc.co.uk. Long-standing listener Peter Minchell from Congleton in Cheshire has done just that, and it's his ideas we'll be putting to our brains today. If, working together, they can't deal adequately with Mr. Minchell's questions, he'll win a modest prize. There's a loose connection between the two questions, as you will see. Peter Minchell asks first, the man with the gong at the start of the Rank Organisation's films was, for many years, the boxer Bombardier Billy Wells. But who actually banged the gong that created the sound effect?
Johnny
Weissmuller.
Johnny Weissmuller.
Should we try that?
Johnny Weissmuller. No, I don't know that he went in for sound effects, did he? The answer was James Blades, Jimmy Blades, a distinguished percussionist, a longtime associate of Benjamin Britten, a professor of percussion at the Royal Academy of Music. One of his most eminent students was Dame Evelyn Glennie. He was equally famous, if not more so, for the ba-ba-ba-boom victory signal, which united the Allies percussively over the radio in World War II. James Blades. Anyway, staying with the theme of unsung contributors in film, who provided the voice of the alien creature in Ridley Scott's 1979 sci-fi classic Alien?
No idea again.
Just thinking, is it Ridley Scott himself?
Yeah, no idea.
Yeah.
Ridley Scott himself?
No, I fear not. No, it was another classic broadcaster, Percy Edwards. You remember Percy Edwards, the well-known animal impersonator of broadcasting fame, who was reputed to be able to imitate the calls of something like 600 different birds. He provided vocal effects on numerous films, including Labyrinth, Orca, and The Plague Dogs. So, thank you. And well done, Peter Minchell. You managed to outwit the brains twice with your questions. So we'll be dispatching your prize with alacrity. And, of course, we can't leave you without the reward that accepts no imitations. This is a genuine radio theatre round of applause. The Before we move on with the contest, let's just remind you how you can submit your ideas for questions to use in this section of the quiz, as well as our email, brainofbritain@bbc.co.uk. You can use paper and envelope and mail them to us at BBC Brain of Britain, Dock House, Media City, UK, Salford M50, 2LH. We just require two intriguing questions, which can be on a common theme or completely unrelated. You can even, as some people do, send us more than two ideas and let us choose the ones we like best. But do try and make sure they're factually correct. You'd be amazed and distressed how many questions we get which are based on myths or hearsay, and which sadly prove to be far from watertight when we start checking the facts. So, fingers back on buttons, and the next round begins with you again, Graeme Anderson. The name of which administrative and religious complex in Lhasa, southern Tibet, means pure land or high heavenly realm?
Sorry, can't remember.
Okay. You're not the only one by the look of it, I think.
Nobody can.
Answer is Potala Palace. I think that was a tough one. I didn't know that either. Daniel Lawson, some music for you. And this is part of a 2019 single by Madonna that also features Juan Luis Londoño Arias, a singer known by the stage name Maluma. Have a listen and then tell me which city provides the title of the song.
Sipping my pain just like champagne. Found myself dancing in the rain with you. I felt so.
Havana?
No. Any more cities now? Yes, Nathan Mulholland.
Barcelona?
No. Graeme Anderson's having a go.
Rio de Janeiro?
No. Yeah, Becky.
Montevideo.
No, it did begin with M. It was Medellin, second largest city in Colombia. Maluma is an award-winning Colombian singer. Now, Becky Lovegrove, first broadcast in 1992, the first two episodes of which British sitcom were titled Fashion and Fat?
Absolutely Fabulous.
It had to be, didn't it? No other competition. Which very familiar form of confectionery was popularised at the World's Fair in St. Louis in 1904?
Candy floss.
Good guess, but no. Daniel Lawson.
Toffee?
No. Graeme Anderson.
Turkish Delight.
No, nice thought. Wasn't.
Chewing gum?
No, it was the ice cream cone. It happened when an ice cream seller found himself next to a waffle seller, so all it took was a twist of a waffle and the two combined, and there was the ice cream cone. Nathan Mulholland. Tony Stark is the alter ego of which comic book and film superhero?
Iron Man.
Yep, you're right. The Tancredo Neves Bridge, also known as the Fraternity Bridge, spans the Iguazu River, connecting which two South American countries?
Chile and Argentina?
No. Graeme Anderson?
Venezuela and Colombia?
No. Becky Lovegrove?
Peru and Bolivia?
No. Daniel Lawson?
Peru and Ecuador?
No, it's Argentina and Brazil. Here's the score at the end of that round. And it's Nathan Mulholland 1, well done. Becky Lovegrove 4, Daniel Lawson 4, Graeme Anderson still on 9. A score which he will try to expand with this question. Which horse, bred from a line of successful racehorses, was buried in 1836 under an oak tree at Stratfield Say, having received a funeral with full military honours after his death at the age of 28?
Copenhagen?
Yes, the Duke of Wellington's horse, Copenhagen. Stratfield Say has been the home of the Dukes of Wellington since 1817. Which US state is known as the land of 10,000 lakes?
Alaska?
No. Nathan Mulholland?
Minnesota?
is the right answer, yes. And just across the border in Canada, the province of Manitoba at one time proclaimed superiority by printing a car license tagline reading, Land of 100,000 Lakes. Likely story. Daniel Lawson, what name, I mean forename and surname, is shared by an English composer and lutenist born in 1583, who wrote the music for several of Shakespeare's plays, including The Winter's Tale and The Tempest, and a pioneering American blues singer and songwriter from the Mississippi Delta?
John Smith?
No. Becky Lovegrove?
John Dowland?
No. Graeme Anderson?
John Hurt?
No. Ah, Mississippi John Hurt, no. That's the closest we've come. No shaking of heads. Robert Johnson is the answer. 350 years apart, these Robert Johnsons, but I like to think they'd have got on quite well together. Plenty to talk about. Becky Lovegrove, music for you. And this is a piece performed by a superstar violinist born in West Germany in 1963. She was invited by the conductor Herbert von Karajan to play with the Berlin Philharmonic at the age of 13. And at the age of 22, was made an honorary fellow of the Royal Academy of Music in London. After we've listened, can you tell me who she is?
Sophie Mutter.
The very same, yes. Married at one time to the late André Previn, who composed violin pieces especially for her. The herb known as coriander in the UK is called what in the USA?
Cilantro.
It is. The musicological term Rabindra Sangeet refers to settings of the poems of which Nobel Prize winning author?
Vikram Seth.
No. Daniel Lawson, though.
Kipling?
No. Graeme Anderson?
Tagore.
Rabindranath Tagore, yes, correct answer. And we come to Nathan Holland again. Sorry We Missed You, released in 2019, is a British film focusing on characters working in what has become known as the gig economy, made by which much-garlanded filmmaker?
Ken Loach.
Is right. The title, of course, refers to the note that delivery drivers routinely post through people's doors. Although the flower William Wordsworth is most commonly associated with is undoubtedly the daffodil, he wrote no fewer than four poems dedicated to another common garden flower, describing it variously as child of the year, nature's favourite, and a little cyclops with one eye. Which flower?
Bluebell?
No. Graeme Anderson.
Daisy.
The Daisy, yep. Dramatic change in scores here. Nathan Mulholland, 3. Daniel Lawson, 4. Becky Lovegrove, 6. Graeme Anderson, 12. And a warning to you all at this point, this has to be the final round, folks. So off we go again with Graeme Anderson. In 1925... the anatomist and anthropologist Douglas Derry did the first recorded autopsy on whose body?
Lenin?
No. Becky Lovegrove?
Tutankhamun.
Is the right answer, yes. He was professor of anatomy at the Government Medical School in Cairo. Daniel Lawson. The 2005 novel Q&A by Vikas Swarup was adapted for a successful film of what title?
Slumdog Millionaire.
Right. Named after the surgeon who was the first to describe it, the McMurray test is used to evaluate individuals for tears in which part of the body?
Esophagus?
No. Becky Lovegrove knows.
Liver.
Not the liver. Graeme Anderson.
Stomach.
Nope. And Nathan Mulholland.
The knee.
The knee is right. It's the meniscus of the knee. Well done. Okay, Becky Lovegrove, this is your question. Only in Britain could a provincial policeman make crass moral pronouncements, be applauded for it by the press and government, and end up knighted. These words were written in a diary entry in 1991 by which artist, theatre designer, and film director?
No.
Okay. No offers? No, there aren't. Okay, shaking of heads. Derek Jarman. I think you will all remember him. And it's fairly obvious that the reference there was to James Anderton, Chief Constable of Greater Manchester, one of his abiding bogeymen. Nathan Mulholland, time for a music question for you. The song you're about to hear is by Eminem, and it features in a 2002 film that starred Eminem as an aspiring rapper known as B-Rabbit. I'd like you to tell me the name of the film.
Oh, there goes Rabbit, he choked. He's so mad, but he won't give up. That is, he know he won't have it. He knows his whole back's at his ropes. It don't matter, he's dope. He knows that, but he's broke. He's so stagnant, he knows when he goes back to this mobile home. That's when it's back to the lab again, yo. This old rhapsody better go capture this moment and hope it don't pass.
You better lose yourself in the music the moment you own it. You better never let it go. You only get one shot. Do not miss your chance to blow. This opportunity.
Eight Mile,
yes, the song Lose Yourself won an Oscar for Best Original Song at the ceremony held in 2003. The James Joyce story The Dead, the closing story in his first collection of fiction, Dubliners, was adapted for the big screen in 1987 and was the last ever movie made by which great American director?
John Ford?
No. Graeme Anderson knows.
John Huston.
John Huston is the point-winning answer. Meaning that, at the end of today's heat of Brain of Britain, the final scores are these. Nathan Mulholland, 5. Daniel Lawson, 5. Becky Lovegrove, 7. Graeme Anderson, 13. Congratulations, Graeme Anderson. Quite an emphatic win. We'll definitely be seeing you again in the semi-finals in the summer. Thanks to all four of you for a splendid contest. Join us next time in Salford as we meet four more potential Brains of Britain. From all of us here today, thank you for listening and goodbye.